You know, there's something about this intro music that really gave me hype to watch a Granto video. Now let's get it. What's up? I'm Grantocreates and I'm back with a brand new video. Today we are going over the in-game mechanic. It's something I should have did a while ago, but we're just getting to it now. We're doing so much content. As I say every video, make sure you like, subscribe, and join the Discord down below, but also make sure you favorite me as your favorite creator on Fortnite. I think that's enough said. Let's go ahead and jump into the actual video. When is the last time I did a mechanic? Like an actual tutorial? At least a good month and a half. Either way, grab a player counter, name it current alive players. Now, player count, do not compare. Enable on phase, do gameplay only. Use zone, turn on. Time in zone, 1 second. And then do 99, 99, 99 for the height with height and everything like that. I did the quick revive video you can find up here. This is the quick revive switch. Either watch that video and see what I did in there or grab that switch. Bring it over here if you already have it. Visible in game, no. Store per player, turn yes. Check state at game start, turn to disable. Go ahead and grab a tracker device. Name this the in-game tracker. Stat to track, events. Target value, zero. Sharing, we're gonna do all. When target is reached, do nothing. Show on HUD, turn off. Tracker title, in-game, that's just for if you wanna see it. Tracker completion ceremony, put no. This is also from another video, so if you haven't seen the quick revive video, make sure you watch it. Go to the revive device, which is just your island's down but not out device. There should be only one. It is called the revive device. Down but not out, enabled, yes. Time to revive is 3 seconds. Shakedowns, turn off. Last man standing mode, this is important, it has to be yes. Pull out a trigger device, name it failsafe in trigger, enable on game start, off, VFX and SFX, keep off. Grab a HUD message device, name this game over message. The message, make sure it's game over. Show for duration, put permanent. Play sound is threat. Placement, top center. Priority is display immediately. Queue message for joining progress players, turn off. The intro animation is fade and zoom. Text color, red. Shadow offset and the outline strength are both 5. Size is 50, but you can mess with the size to make it fit the screen as best as you want it to. Grab a HUD controller device. We're gonna name this in-game HUD, and then you need to change show HUD. We're gonna put no. Show battle pass UI, put show all. Enable during phase, put none. Back over here next to the trigger, pull out a timer device. Name this in-game timer. Duration, 10 seconds. Completion behavior, reset. Timer color, keep it white, it doesn't matter. Display time in, seconds only. Timer text, I mean, you don't need this because it's not gonna be visible, but you can do that. Show and HUD, turn to no. Urgent time, turn on. Because there is stuff you can do with this. I will show you in a sec. Urgency time, 5 seconds. Audio effects, turn off. If instigating player is not present, keep empty. The last device, which is something we don't really use often, but this is probably the first time we're going to use it, is the in-game device. What to end? You're ending the round so that it can start a new round. Winning team, put 100 because you don't want the team that you're on as the winner if you die. Okay, let's put it together. Go back to your player counter. On player counted, send event to. In-game tracker, we're going to increase target value. On player removed, send event to. In-game tracker, we're going to decrement progress. The delay removed trigger, we're going to make that right now. Grab a trigger, name this delay removed trigger. Trigger delay, 0.25. Trigger VFX, off. SFX off. A delay trigger instigator choice, we're gonna do Q. Trigger when receiving from current alive players, on player removed. On triggered, send event to end game tracker, we're going to decrease target value. Okay, so in the revive switch, on turn, send event to end game tracker, we're going to decrease target value. On check result on, send event to end game tracker, we're going to increment progress. Check result off. Send event to in-game tracker, we're going to increment progress. Okay, go to the tracker. Increase target value when receiving from. I need you to add reg revive price on activated and solo revive price on activated, which are all in the quick revive video. So if you don't know what that is, go check it out. But it's just the price of the quick revive. We want you to increment progress when receiving from. Quick revive check switch on turn. On check result on and on check result off. Decrease target value when receiving from. Quick revive check switch on turn off. Delay remove trigger on triggered, which we set that up already. Decrement when receiving from revive device, we are going to do on player revived. So basically it's gonna remove them from the count and it's gonna balance back out. There, go to the trigger, enable when receiving from the game start timer. This cannot be enabled right away, basically. You need to enable this on something to start with. Trigger when receiving from in-game tracker when complete. On triggered send event two, the injured timer, we're going to reset for all, which is in the down state video. Dying effect power up is also in the, maybe the bleed out video. First person camera, we're going to remove from all players, which you know where your first person camera is. So just remove it from all. This is the end game HUD. We're going to enable. And then the game over message we're going to show. Okay, so go to the in-game timer. Start when receiving from the fail safe end trigger. And it's going to be on triggered. On success, send event to in-game device. We're going to activate. Okay, so we can start the game and I can show you how this looks. It literally ends the game immediately. But there is a cool little thing in here, which I think it would be cool for everyone to add. Like say if you want to look at this wall, you could add a fixed point camera. Priority 5, which is the highest priority out of all of the cameras. Enable during always. Add to player on start, turn off. I turn it red just so you know the dip. Transition in time, 0.5. The fade in hold time will be 1 second. Transition in type is fade. Add this to all players when receiving from in-game timer on urgency mode. It makes it more of a cinematic end for your game. Oh no, I'm dying. This game over, we died. Now look at that. Tell me that's not cool. You could literally have this be whatever you want it to be. Okay, so one more thing I wanted to show you before we end the video. We grab quick revive. At the top, you can see where it says we basically got another player because quick revive is basically another player. Okay, so you see that basically it shows one person was down. When you go down, it shows that, okay, you revive yourself, but there's two people down for sure. Now, when you get up, it shows that there's still one person down, but now you lose that extra life, basically having the extra person. So now if another person goes down, or if you go down, which is just two of you, then you lose. Hopefully this system helped. I know this is something that people have been wanting for a while, and I'm just happy to be able to bring this to you guys. As always, I hope you have a nice day. I'll see you in the next video.